welcome back. It's like 30 minutes left of the flights. It's 2:20 p.m. Denmark. And got 300 kilometers left. But I think we can start see the islands in the 3D view. Yes. Let's close the screen. Let's have a look. But we have 300 kilometers left and 30 minutes. And we're cruising in 38,000 feet. That's 1106 kilometers. No, 11.6 kilometers. And there we have all these small islands. But I mostly feel just to get moving. But this is early evening. It will be like 6 p.m. when it will get there. And if I start to fly out on the small islands, I will not be able to go back, maybe, because I have to wait for tomorrow. No, if I fly out like there, I probably not will be able to go back to Male from airport like here. That's something wrong with the runway, but that's maybe something wrong with the photo. I think so. I don't think we have a forest on the runway. Here you have a small city there. Looks like you have some, there's some problem with the satellite photos. But if I'm flying out to there, I'm probably not getting back today, then I cannot continue. But I have my Danish, I'm on an island in the Canary Islands, the Fuerteventura, an island there. So, but we have a lot of small islands, but I'll be back here later, just fly back. If I keep record this, we'll keep go back. This is very big. We cannot just have a look in a few minutes. You can see how many, there's like 20 airports. I will never, that will take me 2 weeks if I should go every airport here. But I should go back later and try to fly to many of the small airports. Then I could read more about the Maldives, the history and all kind of stuff. But I don't think that will be today, because today I just like get moving. Have like 20 airports, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 airports, and then a lot of seaports. But this is the main city, Male. Yes, they have, okay, that's wrong. They have a small city here. No, that's the small capital. With dense streets. So that's very small. You can just walk around here. And they have like 500,000. But I think that's not a cheap place to go, because everything is very expensive. I don't think they have a campground. You can put up a tent, but they have some kind of hotels. I don't think you can get a hotel room like less $50. But maybe they have a cheap motel for backpackers. They maybe have that. They have a backpacker motel to, $20, $30 every night, but I don't think so. That's very expensive. Then we have something up here. Then you can take a boat to like here. There's something here. Well, this is a Muslim country, so probably you cannot go on the street and sit and have a drink. Of course, I don't think the local don't like that, but I think you can, on this expensive tourist islands, I think you can sit, drink alcohol there on the beach, and because they're making a lot of money to selling alcohol. Yes, like in Dubai, you can drink alcohol on the clubs because they're making many millions and billions of dollar income from drunk tourists. But you cannot sit on the streets in Dubai with a cold beer in the harbor like you do in my country, Denmark. You can buy two cold beers and sit on a bench and drink it. You cannot do that in Dubai, I think, and Maldives. And like in the United States, actually, you cannot do that. You cannot drink alcohol public. If you drink two beers, I think the police will arrest you. If you go to the beach in the United States and bring a bag of beer, a six pack, I think the people that will call the police. And even if you're drunk, I think you'll get arrested for public public drunkenness and public drinking. Actually, I think you can get in trouble for that. So you have to think about this. And I think the minimum age in the United States, the minimum sexual age, that's 70 years, or could be 18 years, 70 years. So you have to think of stuff of that if you're traveling and getting drunk. So you cannot drink in the public. So now we can see all this island. We have 200 kilometers left, and we have not started descending. But actually, that's kind of good. Like in the United States, you cannot drink in the public on the streets, because then you don't have a lot of drunk people sitting in parks and drinking alcohol and on the beaches and shouting and playing loud music. So that's kind of good and bad same time. Of course, that's not very good. You cannot sit and drink a cold beer in the harbor or on the beach. But that's good that you don't have this big group of drunk teenagers drinking a lot and playing loud music and shouting and trashing. But I think they do it anyway. They just drive out somewhere. They have some, because they have all these cars in the United States. I think the young teenagers, they drive out somewhere on the remote beaches or forest, have some places they meet and party. Yes, but we have, I don't know, 100 small islands with the tourists. So I'm going to look at all this today, because today I'm a little bit sleepy. Yes, so we have 20 minutes left. So if you are on a beach there in the Maldives and you're getting drunk and you're having sex on the beach and somebody see it, I think you can get in trouble. Because this is a very Muslim country. Yes, I'll go and clean my glasses. But I should use that. I have the Wikipedia, but I'm not going to read all this. I have the Wikipedia about the Maldives here. Yes, if anyone like to read it, they can stop the video, pause the video and read it. Stuff like that. So just scrolling through. Anyone like to read it? They have to stop the video. Buddhists, Islamic periods, colony periods. But maybe you cannot read it on my video. I will look at it later. But actually, I'm going to watch all my how I can fly videos. But I'm just watching my Danish videos. Just scrolling through. Geography, climate. But that's more easy. You just open the Wikipedia yourself. Because there's a lot of stuff to read here. Law, foreign relations, military, human rights, economics, tourism, fishing, demographic, and religion, language. Yes, but I'm not going to read all that. It take me 2 hours to read this. Education, stuff like that. But that's something I should read next time I get here. I will try to read some of that. And I don't have a printer, so I cannot print it out. So we have the sunsets. Yes, and of course we have the photo of the aircraft. That's I think they only have one. That's the only Airbus they have. They only have this one Airbus 320. No, I'm watching my videos. This is my Danish videos, the part 18. So after that I will start watching the English video. I'm not watching any of my English video yet, because I'm just watching my Danish, because I'm so busy to this. But I do this because I like it. So I have to check my cell phone. Power 91. Then I have to check my uploads. But we maybe have an evening flight in like 1 or 2 hours to Dubai or Europe, London, Paris. Yes, I'm still uploading. Don't have any of my. There's no video from this flight public yet. That's because I'm uploading everything same time. But that's fine. This, when I take a break, half an hour, I empty my memory card. Then I start to copy and upload. No, I have to sit up. I think that's the only Airbus they have, the Maldivian. But you can search the Google for if this airline company have a webpage. Do that. But that would take some hours to look all this island if you have to zoom in. If you have to look every island like this, because you take long time to scroll in and out. Like here. So So you have many hunters of these small islands. And they use it for tourists like this. But I think they are very, very expensive. Cost many thousand dollars. Not just $1,000, could a lot more. Could be $500 every day. Many hundred dollars to rent the huts. Like $300 every day at least. So that's not a cheap place to buy. Many people that have a lot of money, they have the money. Here we have the airport, the Male Velina International Airport. Many hundred thousand, many millions people have more than $1 million or many hundred thousand dollars. They can afford to spend $10,000 to a vacation. But that's not all. But many people have like few hundred thousand dollars. They have that. They can afford to spend $10,000, $5,000 or $10,000 just for fun, because they're making good money. They have good work, maybe. They have a good work and saving. They maybe have a business. They have a business giving a good money every year. And they have employees that don't have to be there. They have a kind of money machine. Yes, if you have a shop or restaurant and you have employees, then you have a small kind of money machine making you money. Or it could be a nightclub. If you own a nightclub or five nightclubs, then you're making money every week. What you call it, business owners. If you are a business owner, you're making some money every month or every day. But of course, if you just go to work and you make $10 every hour or $20, you're not going to be rich to do that. To go to work and make $10 every hour or $20. The minimum wage in Denmark is a little bit less. $20 could be $70 or $18. Is if you work in a supermarket, in a discount supermarket, if you work there, you will get like 120 Danish kroners. That's a little bit less, $20. But they not have much money. They have like a little bit more than $3,000, maybe $3,500 before tax. And the tax, that's very high in Denmark. So even you have an income of like $3,500 in Denmark, you can barely, because you have to pay rent apartment, that could be like $1,500. Could be $1,500 just to rent a good two-room apartment. That's 10,000 Danish kroners. So you cannot get an apartment below $1,000 in Copenhagen. Only this social housing. Yes, if you just have to pay the market price, that costs like $8,000 or $9,000. That's like, I don't know, $1,400, something like that.
Good.